Hello everyone. I'll demonstrate how to use GMetrix practice test program for both QuickBooks test candidates and instructors, proctors, and or administrators. First, let's go to GMetrix.net to sign in with your existing account. If you don't have your account yet, I would suggest you watch my previous video to see available options to access GMetrix. Once you access GMetrix and redeem an access code, based on your certification exam type, you should be able to see available practice exam type. In this case, Intuit QuickBooks is available. So I'll click it to see what it happens. We see both QuickBooks Desktop and QuickBooks Online US here. In this video, I'll cover QuickBooks Desktop practice test available mode, the number of questions, allotted time, and so on. So I'll click QuickBooks Desktop. As you see here, GMetrix currently offers two different practice tests, that is test 1 and test 2. If you hover your mouse on each test, you'll see both training mode and the testing mode. As a current QuickBooks exam administrator, I want to point out some differences between the training mode and the testing mode. In terms of the training mode, GMetrix allows you to track your learning progress and provide you with a detailed explanation as soon as you answer to each question. In addition, there is no time limited, so I would suggest test candidates take each practice test with the training mode to be exposed to all questions and the detailed explanation to recap your understanding and to better learn about exam objectives. In terms of the testing mode, GMetrix asks you to answer questions within the specific duration, 15 minutes, that is the same allotted time when taking the QuickBooks certification exam. So I would strongly suggest test candidates take two different tests with a testing mode before attending your scheduled exam session. Since the testing mode looks like an actual certification exam, this mode doesn't allow to track the learning progress. My perspective is that it's important for exam candidates to be familiar with the test interface and controls. So I click Test 1 with the training mode to cover them. By clicking Go to Question icon, enable you to go to a specific question. For instance, you can go to the question 30. From the question 4 that you see here. By clicking Save icon, enable you to save and exit the test then you are currently working on. If you want to do so, you can simply click Save and exit. If not, you can simply click Close the button. By clicking the Zoom icon, enable you to increase or decrease font size of the question text. By clicking the verb icon, enable you to track hints for a question. You can click Previous to return to the previous question. You can click Reset button to restart work on a question if you think you have made an error. You can return a specific item at the end of the test if you select the Mark for Review checkbox. The specific item will be marked in the review screen that appears at the end of the test. By clicking the Skip icon, enable you to skip the question that you want to do so. You can click Next to move to the next question in the exam. Upon completion, in answering all questions, you can click Finish button. Then you should be able to see if you answered to all questions and marked some questions for review. Green checkbox means that you answered. Gray box means that you have not answered yet. Red flag means that you marked for review. By clicking Go to Question icon, enable you to go to question that you select. If you think that everything is all set, you can click Finish button. Then you'll see your test result, including your score, missed question, exam objectives, time spent, and so on. Please note that QuickBooks Desktop Certification Test candidates are asked to answer to 47 questions within the allotted 50 minutes. Here's hoping you do well on your certification exam. Thank you.